Welcome to the next class on international health. This is also one of the miscellaneous topics in community medicine. Not many questions will be asked, but you can have one-off question here and there. So let us see what international health is. First and foremost, we come to the most important organization in the terms of public health, and that is the WHO or the World Health Organization. The birth of the WHO, an interim commission was set up in the conference held at New York, and WHO took birth on 7th April 1948, and therefore 7th April, as you know, is celebrated as the World Health Day. It is celebrated to celebrate this day on which WHO came into existence. So 7th April is known as the World Health Day. Each year WHO releases separate themes to be observed in that year. What I have done is that I have put themes of past couple of years so that in case those appear in the examination, you should know them. WHO is a specialized non-political health agency of the United Nations with the headquarters at Geneva. I would like you to at least write down where the headquarters are. Sometimes straightforward questions are asked as to where the headquarter of a particular agency is. So for WHO, it is in Geneva. The World Health Organization membership, those countries which are not responsible for international relations are associate members. These are all those countries with terrorist background or dictatorial countries where you have dictators or there is no democracy, problem countries, newly formed countries which do not abide by international rules. Those kind of countries are called as associate members. They are members of the WHO, but they cannot vote. So they have no voting rights. They can participate. Associate members, as I said, participate without a vote. Some are members of only WHO and some are members of UN. So UN and WHO, the membership is given separately. All the members obviously contribute to the budget. So they come together, they pool their resources and allocate budgets for the expenditure of WHO. Structure of the WHO. You have the World Health Assembly, the Executive Board and the Secretariat. WHO regional organizations. You have on your left slide the regions of the world and on the right hand side is the headquarters. What is most important is that the headquarters for Southeast Asia region is at New Delhi. The other headquarters for Africa, it is in Harare. The Americas, it is in Washington DC. Europe, it is in Copenhagen. Eastern Mediterranean, it is in Alexandria. And Western Pacific in Manila. What is most likely to ask again is, because we live in India and you are giving Indian examinations, Southeast Asian region and the headquarters is at Delhi. The work of the WHO. Prevention and control of specific diseases. Now this is not again a complete list. This is just a tip of the iceberg. This is just to show you some important works that WHO does. There is automatic telex reply services, weekly epidemiological reports. Now this weekly epidemiological report is an interesting thing. It started way back and is still a very important source of health data. All the new epidemics, all the diseases are covered in the weekly epidemiological report, and it is a very important tool for follow-up of diseases. Then you have non-communicable diseases, vector biology, quality control of drugs follow-up, and expanded program of immunization. So some of the examples wherein specific diseases are prevented and helped by WHO. Development of comprehensive health services, of course, primary health care. So that was formulated, that was propagated by the WHO. Manpower utilization and appropriate technology for health. This means appropriate use of local resources, maximization of local resources. Family health. Under the domain of family health, you have maternal and child health, nutrition, reproductive health, and health education. WHO's work in environmental health. You have basic sanitary health, quality of air, water, food, and radiation. WHO publishes standards for all these factors, and there are also guidelines and procedures of follow-up and procedures of how to do testing as well as monitoring of these parameters. WHO Environmental Health Criteria Program, WHO Environmental Health Monitoring Program, like I told you. Coming to the next, health statistics. Weekly epidemiological records. World Health Statistics quarterly and annually are important publications. International Classification of Disease is another leap that WHO has taken. What is trying to be done is that we have to classify all the diseases so that you can compare and contrast diseases between various countries. Since there was no uniform code of conduct or no classification beforehand with us, ICD was developed. ICD is the International Classification of Disease. Every disease is coded and that code is uniformly followed around the world. Biomedical research. WHO stimulates and coordinates research, and it also stimulates research in tropical diseases such as malaria, filaria, leishmaniasis, leprosy and schistosomiasis. Now this is important because you have to have a body which promotes research in these diseases also. These diseases predominantly are a third world problem these days. These are developing country diseases. Developed countries don't have these diseases to that extent, and therefore obviously they are not interested in pushing their funds into research of these diseases. However, developing countries need that research, they need that funding, and that comes from WHO. Health literature and information. WHO library is the satellite center for MedLIAS, which is the medical literature analysis and retrieval of the United States. So WHO library is a part of MedLIAS. WHO also cooperates with other agencies like the UN, FAO to bring about change. Coming to the next agency, that is UNICEF. UNICEF was established by the United Nations General Assembly in 1946. The headquarters of UNICEF is in New York. Regional offices are in New Delhi, which is the South Central Asian region head office. The executive board has 30 nations in UNICEF. UNICEF and WHO work together on urgent problems in India like malaria, tuberculosis and venereal disease. So these are specific Indian diseases wherein WHO and UNICEF collaborated. Later assistance to nation in MCH, nutrition, environmental sanitation, water supplies, health education was provided. Recently, since UNICEF is basically a child health organization, the tendency is to turn away from programs of eradication unless they benefit the children, because these programs take up a lot of resources and the results are not that much encouraging. So unless and until children are involved, UNICEF would not be very much likely to help them. Initially, they were very much focused on children. Then they said, okay, we will take up measures which are protective for children. And there, that is where you see here environmental sanitation, water supplies, health education. So these were issues surrounding child health. These were indirect interventions which had a bearing on the child health. So UNICEF later on took that. Now it says we are getting too much of expenditure, so we will focus on diseases which are directly related to child health and elimination if a disease is a candidate, okay. Otherwise, those resources could be better utilized elsewhere. Concept of whole child is gained. Whole child is again not just pure child health but associated factors which have an impact on child health. The content of services of UNICEF. First, child health. Because it has done a long list, we also have that list here. It has contributed in vaccines and seras, BCG vaccination program, penicillin plant near Pune in India, DDT plant, two plants for iodized salt and triple vaccine, environmental sanitation for safe drinking water, primary health care to mother and children, and service delivery economically at village level through volunteers. So these are the domain of work of UNICEF under child health. Child nutrition, you have applied nutrition program, supplementary nutrition in schools, agricultural extension, supplied modern dairy products in cities, also provision of large doses of vitamin A. If you look at the bottles of vitamin A, many times you will find that it is a UNICEF supply. Enrichment of salt with iodine, they provided us with technology for iodination of salt, iron and folate supplementation for anemia, and encouraging national food and nutritional policies. In the domain of child and family welfare, UNICEF has contributed in the way of parent education, daycare centers, child welfare, youth agencies and women's club through health, nutrition and education. Education, UNICEF participates in formal as well as non-formal education. Improvement of teaching science, supply of books, laboratory equipments, reagents, this is also done by UNICEF. There is a very famous campaign called as Gobi Triple F campaign, and it has G for growth charts, O for ORS, B for breastfeeding, I for immunization, F for female education, another F for family planning, and the last F for supplementary feeding. So this is the Gobi Triple F campaign. You should know this because this is something unique and can be asked in the examination. Coming to the next agency, you have UNDP or United Nations Development Program. UNDP is basically the main funding agency for a lot of programs. So UNDP is the main source of funds for technical assistance to a lot of programs. It helps poorer nations to develop human and natural resources fully so that they don't have to rely on foreign aid. UNDP covers virtually every economic and social sectors such as agriculture, industry, education and science, health and social welfare. So UNDP funds almost every aspect of health. Next is UNFPA, which is United Nations Fund for Population Activities. That is UNFPA. As the name itself suggests, it operates in the field of family welfare. UNFPA funds national level schemes, area projects for family planning in rural areas. It is involved in the manufacture of contraceptives, population education programs, organized sector projects to strengthen program management. It also works to improve output at the grassroots level of health workers and introduction of innovative approaches in family planning. So basically everything under the family planning, anywhere you hear family planning, that is UNFPA. So family welfare, UNFPA function. The next organization is FAO or Food and Agricultural Organization. FAO has headquarters in Rome. FAO helps nations to raise living standards. It basically wants nations to be independent as far as their own food supplies are concerned. So the growth of these nutrients should be adequate so that nations do not supply or nations do not affect by malnutrition. It increases the efficiency of farming, forestry and fisheries, and it works for betterment of the condition of rural people. The World Bank, if you all know, we take loans from the World Bank, huge amounts of loans. World Bank gives loans to all the member countries. So World Bank helps less developed countries to raise their standards of living. There are loans for economic growth. There are a lot of loans for India's population projects. Electric power, roads, railways, agriculture, water, education, family planning, health and environment. These are the various sectors under which the World Bank gives loans. If you compare World Bank and UNDP, they give loans to a lot of things. So World Bank is an organization you want to know, which lends loans for developmental activities. The next is ILO or International Labour Organization, again the headquarters in Geneva, like WHO. ILO contributes to the establishment of lasting peace by promoting social justice. The name itself tells you, International Labour Organization, which means it deals with labor issues. So these are the objectives: to promote through international action labor conditions and standard of living. So the conditions of laborers, their standard of living improvement is a function of the ILO. The International Labor Code is a collection of international minimum standards of health, welfare, living and working conditions of the workers. This is something you should know. The International Labor Code given by the ILO. Not very difficult to remember. You have a lot of bilateral agencies, and one such agency is USAID. USAID in India is present in New Delhi again. USAID is involved in malaria eradication, medical education, nursing education, health education, water and sanitation, communicable disease, nutrition and family planning. A lot of them. Recent trend of USAID is reduction of activities in public health field, but more emphasis on agricultural and family planning activities. When you look at those lists, don't get intimidated. You are not expected to remember all those points, but you should know basically what domain the agency operates, so that if you have that odd one out, you can answer it. Also, what is expected is that you at least know the headquarters. Coming to SIDA, you have Swedish International Development Agency. SIDA has assisted National Tuberculosis Control Program notably. It has given X-ray units, microscopes, anti-tubercular drugs, short course chemotherapy and also given drug regimens. So SIDA has a hand in the tuberculosis control program. Coming to DANIDA, DANIDA is Danish International Developmental Agency, which is a Government of Denmark function, and Danida has contributed to National Blindness Control Program. Now, since this is easy, you should know this. Danida has contributed to the National Blindness Control Program, and SIDA has contributed to the National Tuberculosis Control Program. Non-governmental agencies, or you can say NGOs, non-governmental organizations. These are not governmental organizations. They have a private body, private meeting, they have private funding, and they employ people who are salaried or volunteers and work in the field. So these are NGOs. One such NGO is the Rockefeller Foundation, founded by Mr. John D. Rockefeller. Mainly public health and medical education are the function of Rockefeller Foundation. Notably, All India Institute of Hygiene and Public Health in Calcutta was founded by the Rockefeller Foundation. So again, this is something you should know because it is very peculiar. All India Institute of Hygiene and Public Health in Calcutta was founded by Rockefeller Foundation. They have these exchange programs, training abroad of candidates from India through fellowships and grants. So people from India have a chance to go outside on a scholarship offered by the Rockefeller Foundation. The next foundation, the well-known foundation, is the Ford Foundation. Ford Foundation has worked in rural health services and family planning. They also help in orientation training centers in public health, research come action projects. A huge success is the RCA latrine, which was because of the research done by the Ford Foundation. Pilot project in rural services such as Gandhi Gram, establishment of NIHEA in New Delhi, that is another institute you want to know, was founded with the help of Ford Foundation. Calcutta Water Supply and Drainage System, Ford Foundation, and Family Planning Programs. The next organization we are going to see is CARE, which is Cooperative for Assistance and Relief Everywhere. CARE is the world's largest independent, non-profit, non-sectarian organization. So it is on a very large scale. CARE provides emergency aid and long-term development assistance. It gives food for children 6 to 11 years of age. It also supports the ICDS. It also supports ICDS in India. Integrated nutrition and health projects, and it helps for better health and nutrition. So what you need to know is CARE supports ICDS. We also saw that Danida supports blindness control program and SIDA, the tuberculosis control program. Also, you won't want to remember the headquarters. CARE also supports anemia control project. It works for improving women's health, improved health for adolescent girls project, child survival project, improving women's reproductive health, and Konkan integrated development project. These are the various projects that CARE has undertaken. Coming to the Indian Red Cross, the functions of Indian Red Cross are relief work, milk and medical supplies, armed forces rehabilitation, maternal and child welfare, family planning, and blood bank and first aid. If you know a bit of history of Red Cross, you know that they were basically into armed forces. They were basically a service which was meant for the soldiers in the war. Later on, they extended in peacekeeping activities, and this is what they are involved in right now. Miscellaneous organizations are Hindu Kush Nivaran Sangh, previously called as British Empire Leprosy Relief Association or BELRA. They have publications of leprosy in India and financial assistance to leprosy homes and clinics. Also, they support education and training activities. With that, we conclude the chapter of international health.